Okay, so my phone died. It ran out of space. So halfway through my wonderful, glorious unboxing, cuts out. So I'm not sure why I'm going to update. Upload both or one or not, I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna stop gabbling in case the same thing happens again. So we're doing this lovely Vida Viking Norwegian gin inspired by the lovelies from Norway. And this has been cooling for a while, so I'm actually gonna give this a taste. Ooh. Yeah, it's nice. It's quite green. Not sure how to describe that, but it's quite green. It tastes quite herby. It's a little bit floral, but mainly herby. It's quite a kind of, how some herbs can be quite sweet, so like basil and mint and those kind of things. It's not like that. It's like the other side of it. So it's a much more kind of, they're fresh, but it's almost like pine, or it's quite, it's nice. It's quite a kind of deep, rich taste to it. I'm changing my mind on the floral. I don't think it's floral at all. I think it's quite a sort of, quite kind of woody and rich. And yeah, tastes quite herby, but in a kind of green, mossy kind of way. In a nice way. Definitely mellows after a little bit. I think your palate becomes more accustomed to it. And you get less of the harshness that initially hits you. And then it's got quite a, like a green taste to it. So it's quite sort of, mossy. There's a bit right at the back that you kind of, it's not sweet, but it's not as green as the rest of it. And it's just, you don't get it straight away. When you first drink it, you get quite a kind of green mossiness to it. And then there's a sort of an interesting thing going on at the back of your taste buds. I don't quite know how well to explain that, but it's really nice. It's a nice one. Last week's one was the Boatyard Distillery, last month's Boatyard Distillery, and that was definitely very fresh. It had quite a lot of kind of citrus in it, and very, very different flavours. This one, it's much more kind of earthy. I can kind of imagine the sort of being outside in a nice mountain ranged wood, that kind of thing. But yeah, it's nice. Yeah, there it is. It kind of opens up a little bit as you're drinking it. It's nice though. The tonic water that I also got with it was one of the Frank Benson's then. I'm a bit sad that I didn't get the rhubarb, but I suppose I've got this to go with it so I can add the two together. I'm guessing this is something that's probably going to taste quite good with this specific gin, so I think the rhubarb will bring out that whatever's going on at the back there that gives it that little sweet note. I'm hoping I'm not just talking rubbish here, but this is the way that it tastes to me anyway. I'm conscious of the time, so I'm going to cut this off and cut this short. But I think this is a absolutely beautifully bottled gin. It tastes really interesting, so I'm going to be looking forward to trying it with different things, different kind of mixes, maybe some syrups in there as well. It's good stuff. So watch the other one. If you want to know about another gin, if you want to sign up for yourself, Craft Gin Club, check them out online. They're on social media as well, but they'll do discounts as well. So if you want a recommendation, you can message me and I'll give you the recommendation. It means that I get some money off and you get some money off your first box as well. So it's all good. So if you feel like doing it and you want to help me out, then yay! Like I said before, this is not sponsored by them. They've got no, they haven't given me any freebies or anything for this. So this is just me trying something out. It's a good way of you know, getting on with different gins or whatever. So yeah, there you go. All right, so we'll see you next time.